shit's just crazy, like. The whole energy out here is just changing, you know? It's just getting dark, man, quick.
A famous poet once said, "Every day a star is born." That was most definitely the case 34 years ago, on October 24th, 1986. Canada native Aubrey Drake Graham would go on to become the top-selling male solo artist of all time, breaking every record imaginable while redefining what success looked like as a music artist. Although Drake is responsible for songs and albums that went on to define the sound of the time, some moments truly stand out in his career. His legacy is made up of many moving parts, and some of them just so happen to be huge moments in modern pop culture. This video will highlight some of Drake's biggest and bestest, from collaborations, beef, songs, and videos, all on the long road to becoming one of the biggest artists ever. In 2009, Drake signed to Young Money Entertainment, a label group under Birdman's Cash Money, run by Drake's mentor and fellow rapper, Lil Wayne. From then on, Wayne, Drake, and Nicki Minaj would team up and produce hit after hit, from songs like Every Girl to Bedrock with Nicki Minaj. Drake, Nicki, and Wayne would all go on to be considered at one point or another the best in the world. It was like vintage OKC with Harden, KD, and Russ. Cash Money was a relatively young label at the time, and to score three superstar artists was unheard of. But this was only the beginning. The songs they made would become modern day classics and help launch Drake's young career even more into the spotlight, elevating everyone else with him. To this day, Hotline Bling is one of Drake's biggest songs, also winning the 2017 Best Rap Song Grammy Award. The music video sits at over 1.6 billion views and has 8.6 million likes. Financed totally by Apple as part of Drake's Apple Music deal, this video would go on to become one of YouTube's top 100 viewed videos, but the star of the video was of course Drizzy's dance moves. Drake dancing along with the millions of memes that followed helped to make this song a massive success, even sparking an SNL parody starring none other than Donald Trump himself. If you hadn't heard of Drake before, you had now. God's Plan is another huge song accompanied by an even bigger music video. 1.2 billion views and 12 million likes. The premise of the video is that Drake gives away nearly $1 million in cash, cars, groceries, and scholarships, even writing a check for $50,000 for a University of Miami student, and giving away $20,000 to a Miami fire department. The song won the Grammy for the Best Rap Song and the BET Award for Music Video of the Year. Even haters couldn't help but admit that if Drake did all this just to look good, he still changed real people's lives along the way. While Drake isn't known for being confrontational, he has had a few beefs in his career. The first one being with Philadelphia's finest, Meek Mill, in 2015. This all started after Meek took to Twitter saying, "Stop comparing me to Drake. He doesn't write his own raps." Meek actually thought that Drake was dissing him on a feature Drake did for Meek on a song called Rico, where Drake said, "The girl of your dreams to me is probably not a challenge," seemingly referring to Nicki Minaj, Meek's then girlfriend. It was later confirmed that Drake had received help from a ghostwriter, Quentin Miller, on several tracks, including Drake's 10 bands. Drake was furious and immediately dropped a track called Charged Up as a response. But before Meek ever had a chance to respond, Drake would drop another track called Back to Back. This song was the first diss track in history to be nominated for a Grammy and was famous for the lines, "Is that a world tour or your girl's tour?" Meek then responded using the reference track from Drake's ghostwriter, Quentin Miller, on a song called Wanna Know. The beef continued for the next couple of years, with both Meek and Drake sneak dissing in songs and at shows. But in 2018, Drake brought Meek out on stage at a show in Boston to perform Dreams and Nightmares, publicly squashing the beef. At the 2017 Billboard Music Awards, Drake beat Adele's 2012 record and became the biggest single year winner ever, taking home 13 wins total, including Top Artist, Top Male Artist, Top Billboard 200 Artist, Top Hot 100 Artist, Top Song Sales, Top Streaming Songs, Top Rap Artist, and more. Drake was in and out of his seat all night collecting trophy after trophy, and when he finally won the most coveted Top Artist, Drake brought his whole crew on stage, including his dad, Lil Wayne, and Nicki Minaj. Minaj. After finishing his speech, he took a shot of his signature whiskey, Virginia Black, and then walked off stage. Drake would also go on to give an explosive performance in the middle of Bellagio Fountain, surrounded by constant fireworks, adding to an already unbelievable night. Drake signed his deal with Jordan Brand back in 2013, joining the small list of artists to have a signature shoe. Out of this collaboration, we saw shoes like the Air Jordan 10 in 2016, the Air Jordan 12 in 2017, and the Air Jordan 8 the following year. But in 2018, rumors began to spread of Drake's unhappiness with Nike and the lack of creative control that he had. Seeing how fellow musicians Pharrell and Kanye were faring over at Adidas, talks with Adidas and Drake began. Drake began publicly wearing Adidas as well as Yeezy apparel, seemingly leading fans to believe the Nike collaboration was a thing of the past. Despite all this, later that year, amid Drake's beef with Pusha T, the talks with Adidas were ended. At the time, it was rumored that Drake planned to reveal his son named Adidon to the world as a part of an Adidas campaign. And when Pusha T beat Drake to the punch with his song called Story of Adidon, Adidas dropped Drake. This story was later proved false as Drake sat down with Rap Radar for a 2-hour interview in his Toronto mansion, where he had this to say. After the failed Adidas campaign, Drake and Nike reunited. And most recently, Drake has flexed his affiliation with the brand in videos such as Laugh Now, Cry Later, filmed totally at Nike headquarters, with cameos from professional athletes Kevin Durant, Odell Beckham Jr., and Marshawn Lynch. The brand deal with Nike ultimately helped increase the popularity of Drake's personal brand, October's Very Own. While Drake is no stranger to features, this one did come as a surprise to a lot of people. The Six God himself and up-and-coming Memphis rapper Blockboy JB broke the internet with the music video to a song titled Look Alive. While this was not a Drake song, it did go to show just how much a Drake feature and cosign could do for someone's career. This one song was enough to elevate Blockboy JB to stardom overnight. Although he had been gaining attention in Memphis and elsewhere, the Drake cameo and feature did more than any amount of promotion could. The Drake stimulus package was in full effect, and has since played an important role in elevating many up-and-coming artists, from Tuesday with I Love Maconan, Yes Indeed with Lil Baby, to many others. While a Drake cosign isn't enough to sustain a career forever, it has taken some artists from up-and-coming to superstars. In 2018, on Pusha T's album Daytona, Push took some shots at Drake for using a ghostwriter on a song called Infrared. Not even a day later, Drake dropped a song called Dubby Freestyle, dissing Pusha T and Kanye, the owner of Good Music to which Pusha T is signed. Pusha T then claps back at Drake with a diss track titled The Story of Adidon, in which Push announces to the world that Drake actually has a son whom he has been hiding from the world, as well as takes huge shots at Drake's family and friends. Drake then took to Instagram to clear up some of the allegations and rumors surrounding the whole thing. And at the urging of Drake's mentor, hip-hop legend and label owner Jay Prince, Drake would not release another diss track, despite having one prepared, but instead decided to let things stay where they were before they escalated any further. In My Feelings was a true viral moment if there ever was one. The day after Drake released his album Scorpion, Instagram comedian and personality Shiggy posted a video dancing to Drake's song In My Feelings. The video ended up going crazy. Odell Beckham Jr. actually posted his own video of the dance, tagging Shiggy and hashtagging Do The Shiggy, making it into a challenge. After that, it was a snowball effect. Big name celebrities, artists, and normal people were all posting their versions of the Shiggy challenge. In My Feelings ended up going number one, with it thanks to a massive viral moment behind the song. Drake's use of social media trends and dancing to produce mega hits is almost down to a science, starting with Hotline Bling, In My Feelings, Nonstop, and now with Toosie Slide. Toosie is a known dancer from Atlanta who had previously been on tour with Future. One day, Drake sent him over an unfinished song and asked if him and his boys could come up with a dance to it. The video they sent back and posted would start blowing up on Instagram. The comments were filled with people fiending for the new Drake song. After the song was finished, Drake ended up naming it Toosie Slide after the dancer who created the dance. With the song and dance going hand in hand, Drake had another viral hit on his hands yet once again. Up, bitch, from Belize, yeah. Visa, I see Drake has continued to stay relevant most recently with songs and videos such as Life is Good and Laugh Now Cry Later. Drake understands the importance of contextualizing a song using viral dances and videos, all in efforts to make the moment as big as possible. With his anticipated album slated to release in 2021, it's safe to assume that this will be Drake's biggest moment yet, with his last album Scorpion setting streaming records of 300 million first day and over a billion streams first week. I think what Drake has in store will be even more crazier.